Hey folks, so what day is it today? Is it Tuesday? I guess it is Tuesday because we had the Air Asia plane tickets on Monday, and this is the day after Monday, so therefore it would be Tuesday. And I'm sitting here in the nice little park that is just up the road from Riva Surya, our little hotel here in Bangkok. This is the park with the fort in it, so I think I did a little tour of this area before, doing the whole Let's Live stuff way back when. And so we are here sitting on the ground because I figured this was a nicer area to do the video in, at least with a tree above me. But I am still in no condition to do any more Let's Live videos right at the second. I am doing better today with the food poisoning deal. But still not perfect. I'm at the point where all your joints hurt. So like getting food poisoning, right? So food poisoning, how it goes. So when I first got food poisoning, I kind of just felt bloated and really just did not feel hungry at all. Just had this, oh, I don't want to eat anything, right? And then you start getting the horrible headaches, the horrible, just brutal headaches. And then you get the diarrhea. And then you get the vomiting. And then you get the don't want to eat, don't really want to do anything, you just drink fruit juice and soda and have a horrible headache and stay awake and basically sleep and just in and out of sleep for 24 hours. And then after that, you still have a bit of a headache, but you just kind of feel lethargic. And then after that, you get a day like today where it's just like you got a little bit of a headache, not a horrible headache, but it's just still that kind of like lethargy, and it's like all your joint, like your hips hurt and your elbows hurt, and it's all of this kind of stuff. And so that's where I'm at today. Hopefully by tomorrow I will be a bit better. Hopefully by tomorrow I'll be able to do a little bit more exploration of Bangkok. But today, basically not much. I got up this morning, went to the little place that we like to go for breakfast, had breakfast there. A little bit later, went out for some Starbucks coffee. Honestly, didn't want coffee. That's how you can tell I'm sick. I barely had any coffee in like 3 days. Honestly, didn't want the coffee, but I figured if I could stomach the coffee, it would wake me up a little bit. Because one of the problems you run into, especially with these kind of sicknesses, is it really screws with your sleep cycle. Because you never really feel awake, you never feel vibrant. So you kind of are in and out of sleep all day. And so it's not like you're rested, but on the other hand, when it's time to go to sleep at night, you also aren't really tired enough to go to sleep at night. So it's like, it's kind of like you're in and out of sleep all day, and then you're in and out of sleep all night, and it's just a bad thing. So I figured if I had some coffee this morning, that would keep me up at least through the day. So that's been working out for me. So I had that. Then about 2 o'clock, I went to have lunch. I had a vegetarian baguette and French fries. I know some of the jackasses out there be like, oh, look at Eli, he's in Thailand eating French fries. And all I have to say is, fuck you. Because let me tell you again, when you've had food poisoning, basically you're looking at all the food and you're like, what's the safest thing? And you're like, something that is deep fat fried. It may not be good for the heart. I'm not saying it's good for the cholesterol, but at least you know everything in there is dead. Again, I think that's one of the hardest things with food poisoning, because I've had food poisoning quite a few times in foreign countries, is again, it's not even the food poisoning itself, is that when you go back to start eating again, and you're so like skittish, you just have such like shell shock. You're just like, I don't know what I can eat. And that can be a really difficult thing. But I'm happy, so I've been eating a little bit of solid food now. So last night, like literally, you want to talk about ridiculous meals. Last night I had a fruit plate, because again, fruit cut up is pretty healthy. And then I had French fries with my fruit plate. Yes, yes, French fries with my fruit plate. So I had that last night. Then this morning I had fruit with some yogurt and muesli. That was pretty good on my system. I had a coffee. And then I had, a little vegetarian baguette. Had some cheese on it, but like a normal hard cheese. In a restaurant that has people going through all the time with French fries. So I feel a little bit better than now. So that's good. Start pooping again. Pooping's always a good thing. Again, that's one of the weird things, like when your body just stops doing what it normally does. And it's like when you just don't go at all for like a day and a half, because there's just nothing in your system. So it's the little things in life, the little things. It's looking into the toilet and going, look, I birthed that. I know. You may think it's disgusting, but I tell you what, it is a proud, proud moment once you're getting over a disease. But, so, yeah, that's my life here in Bangkok right now. Not overly exciting. I say, just kicking back in this Riva Surya place. It's nice. It's got a nice, really soft bed, which is good when you're not feeling well. It's got really good air conditioning, which is good when you're not feeling well. It's got good internet. Been able to upload a few videos, a few backlog videos. That's good. The only bad thing with Riva Surya is that it's the weirdest freaking English TV selection. Like, it would be one thing if they didn't have any English TV at all. If they had no English TV at all, I'd be like, okay, I understand that. I'm in Thailand. But they have, like, the weirdest English TV selection. They have, like, BBC and RT, which you don't really get RT. And then they have, some of these other weird, weird ones. They have, like, 10 English language channels that are just the bizarrest English language channels in the world. And I don't know. I have somebody looking at me for some reason. Look, they're looking at me.
What?
Hi. Shh. It's like, this is my job. All right.
You do a movie, really?
Yes, yes, I do a movie. I'm a vlogger. I work on YouTube.
Huh?
Apparently I have a friend now. Look, I have a friend. See? Yep. I sit there and I talk into the camera. That's what I do for a job.
Where are you from?
I'm from the United States.
Huh?
I'm from the United States. United States, USA.
USA.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Where are you from?
Yeah, see you right there.
You see me now?
Yeah, yeah, see you right now.
Oh,
the whole world is gonna see you. The whole world. Yeah. So, yeah. This is what I do for a living. I talk into a camera. Yep. So, anyways, what was I saying to this camera? Oh well, we'll have a camera. We'll have our buddy.
Not see me.
Well, if you want to sit by, if you want to sit by me, then you get to be in the camera. Yep. Everybody's always interested when I talk into the camera. See, I talk into the camera, and then I upload this to YouTube. And I have lots and lots of fans on YouTube. The whole world will see you. The whole world will know who you are.
Me,
who are you?
God.
Who are you? What's your name?
Hi.
Hi. Yeah.
How long in Bangkok?
Well, I've been here a day. I'm leaving tomorrow.
So. You can live every day where you cannot go home.
No.
I want to go home. 1 week, 2 weeks,
yeah.
I have no money, I have no money. Very bad in line now.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm from Phuket.
You're from Phuket? Ah, Phuket's very beautiful. Yeah, friend of Phuket, yeah.
I know Phuket is really cool there, but I believe my friend. I said to my friend, bad friend.
Yeah.
When she bring me Bangkok, she go away. She yeah. Don't come to see me.
No.
Every day I walk around here.
No, yeah.
On the night I walk around, come down road, walk around everywhere. Cannot sleep.
Yeah.
Today go very hot. Oh, no,
can I go back to my camera? Alright. So, anyways, I still got my buddy here. What was I saying before? It's always weird when people come up and they start looking at me and start talking to me and they start doing like this in the background. Like, this is my job. That's what I do. I don't know what to say now. Let's see here. So, do you like Bangkok at all? Do you like Bangkok? No, you don't like Bangkok?
I don't like. I want to go home because I need not somebody help me.
Yeah.
In my home, I have somebody, I have people. Now I cannot go. I have no money. But hindi ipantalo.
Alright, I'm gonna start walking, so see you later. Yep, gonna do a movie. So, anyways, yeah, I don't know. What the hell am I supposed to say? Yeah, I'm a bastard. Just like, you know, like I say, you come to these places, you come to these countries, it's like, I don't know what to tell you. Your social system is screwed up. I don't know what to say. So that's what people do. They sit down beside you and they tell you their horrible stories. And they generally do have horrible stories. Don't get me wrong. They have really bad stories. But then it's like, but everybody does. Like, so many people do. And you're like, what am I? I don't know. You know? But that's the reality. That is life. So what do? I pick up my camera and move on. What would you do? What do you do? It's not what would you do. It's always funny in life. Everybody talks about, well, what I would do is, well, I'll bugger off. What do you do? What? Oh no, you're not allowed to ask me that question, right? I'm supposed to be able to put other people down and not actually have to do anything. Anyways, let me see if I can find a nice shady spot over here. Again, it is weird. Like being around here. Oh, darn it. I wanted that shady spot. Let's see if there's another shady spot. Oh, I feel sick. I don't want to walk. That's why I got a nice little place to sit down. Because I didn't want to deal with people. I just wanted to talk to my stupid camera. I wonder if I have my spot back again. She left. It's hard though. I don't know. Again, what do? So many hungry people. So many people that are hard up. That's a weird thing, like when you come to countries, especially like I say with Thailand. There's one thing like when you go to countries that are completely just screwed. But then you come to Thailand and it's like, again, you've got skyscrapers and you've got good internet and you've got lots of amazing, wonderful things. And then you've got lots and lots and lots of really poor people all at the same time. What do you do? What do you do? I don't know. Pick up your camera, keep walking. Let me see. Ooh, I think I can find a nice little spot over there. I can run away. Yeah. It is also funny too, like why when you come to the places, so many people like look for the white people. They like glom onto the white people. And you're like, hey, why don't you talk to the locals? Why don't you ask the locals for help? It's like, oh, because they don't care. bum ba bum ba bum ba bum ba bum. Ooh, look at that. Nice little spot down there. Maybe we'll get the nice little spot down there. Oh, people just trying to screw up my mental thought, my mental calculus. And I lose it. Again, as I say, that's the hardest thing with doing this kind of business. Especially when you're doing what I do, where you try to sit here and talk for 2 hours at a shot. It's just kind of one of those things where you kind of get this mental, you start thinking about things. You get this idea in your head, and then you start talking. And the talking is as much magic as anything else. So people come in and start screwing with you, start trying to talk to you, and it really mucks you up. So that's one thing. If you ever see anybody YouTubing or vlogging, just stay the hell away. Just don't try to get involved, because they have a job to do, and they are doing work. You know? All I'm trying to do is do my job, man. That's all I'm trying to do. I'm trying to put in my honest hour's work for an honest hour's pay. So anyways, I'm now nice and hidden. Hopefully I'm hidden far enough that nobody comes up to talk. Though there is a person up to the right that's giving me a strange look now. And what is it with these white people talking into cameras? I just don't understand. I will not be microaggressed. You will not microaggress me. YouTube content creator equality. Oh well. Fact of the matter is most people don't even know what vlogging is yet. So I guess I shouldn't feel too bad. You know what I'm saying? But anyways, that is a nice thing that I find. Like doing the, doing the Let's Live when I'm able to walk around, even if people give me strange looks, at least I keep walking and therefore they can't really bug me too much. The problem is when I sit down in an environment like this where there are people around, then they kind of come up and start doing stupid stuff. The reason is because I'm just sitting here, basically. But again, as I say, the problem is right now, all of my joints and everything else hurt, so I don't really want to walk around Calazon Road. Because it is about 101 degrees today. It is still pretty hot. It's actually nicer than it was before. Again, when I was here before, it was like 104 degrees. So it's down to 101 degrees. It's down to 101 degrees, which is much nicer, but it is still 101 degrees. When in comparison, Baltimore, it's only 70 degrees right now. So, it'd be weird to be back to Baltimore. And we're going to be back to Baltimore in, like I say, 48 hours or so. So we're here today. Then we're here theoretically. Basically, it's all of tomorrow, but not really in the way you think about it. It's like the 24 hours of tomorrow, but at 2 o'clock in the morning on Thursday. So essentially tomorrow night is when we take off on the airplane. And that'll be a 24-hour flight. Okay, so let's see if I can get my brain back in gear. I was going to be talking about perspectives today. That was my whole idea. Is talking about perspective until a whole random person walks in. But that's what you get with Let's Live videos. You know, and that's the thing. You know, when you're watching PewDiePie and he's doing Let's Plays, like, random people don't walk into his living room and start saying, "Oh, I am from Phuket." That's what you get in Let's Live. And then you can decide. You can decide in the real world what you would do. And then you can go do it. But anyways, I was going to talk about perspectives today because I was curious. I was talking to my wife yesterday or the day before about this whole trip and our perspectives of it. And she was saying that actually that she disagrees with me that on my videos and everything, I've been kind of down about the trip. I've kind of been a little blasé about the trip. But that she actually thinks it's gone pretty well. She didn't like Pattaya. She wasn't overjoyed about Pattaya. But otherwise, she liked Bangkok while we were here. She liked Ayutthaya while we were there. She didn't quite like Pattaya, but it was good enough. And then she really liked Siem Reap. Both really liked Siem Reap. And so it was interesting because she was saying, you know, "Eli, you know, you're getting so down about this trip and talking about, oh, how it hasn't gone to plan and this and that and the other thing." When in reality, she said, you know, I've had a good time on this trip and I feel like it's been a very successful trip and I'm very happy with it and I'll be happy to get home, but I don't feel like this trip has been a failure. And so it is curious to look at one story, at a single story, where you have two people on the same story, where even with that same story, you can have two adults that come up with two entirely different perspectives. And so for my wife, right, she looks at this as all going pretty well. Because again, we got the round trip tickets here for a very good price, like a third the price other people wanted to charge. So even though we've decided to reschedule our tickets, it's still substantially less expensive than if we'd used Thai Airlines or British Airways or anybody else. So we still have a much better flight than if we'd used British Airways or somebody else. We still have paid less than half if we had used British Airways or somebody else, even with the rescheduling, right? So even though we're not spending the entire 6 weeks here, even though spending a little over three weeks here, the price of the tickets, that's not a bad thing. And she said, you know, for her, she came here, you know, Bangkok was very nice, Ayutthaya was very nice. She found Pattaya, again, to be okay, not great, and then she really liked Siem Reap. And so she came to all the, you know, these different places, and for her, it was a pretty good experience all in all. She feels that there was nothing lost, and so she feels like this was a very successful trip. And it's interesting to look at it, because for me, like I say, I've been like bitching and moaning and whining about the trip, talking about how it hasn't gone to plan and this and that and the other thing. And so one of the things, like for me, like my perspective on it, is one of the issues is it hasn't gone to plan. So I thought this was going to be about a 6 week trip. And so I had a plan. And again, it's good being in a Thai country, which is a Buddhist country. And they say, desire brings pain. So I had a plan. That totally went off the rails with the whole heat wave I didn't realize was happening, right? So my idea was to come here, go from Bangkok to Ayutthaya to Sukhothai, spend a week in Chiang Mai, spend a week in Chiang Rai, do a couple of other things, hand over Siem Reap, down to Phuket or Krabi or something like that, and then go out. So I had a plan. I had a plan. Now here's the thing, my wife did not have a plan. My wife was winging it. And so if you're winging it, you can't screw up the plan because you don't have a plan. Now, if you don't have desire, you can't lose what you don't, right? And so since I had a plan, I've been bummed because we couldn't do that plan because of the heat and all those kinds of things, right? So there's one thing going on there. Then the other thing is, you know, when you look at perspectives and all that kind of stuff, is I've basically been on bed rest for 1 week out of the 3 weeks that we've been here. So although my wife has had to baby me a little bit, the reality is that she actually hasn't had to go through, you know, cellulitis and 4 days of bed rest on that. And then now, you know, the food poisoning, and now we're going into our third day of dealing with that, right? So for her, she hasn't been sick and all that kind of stuff. So for me, I had this big plan. Then we got here, the heat caused a lot of problems for me, a lot of problems that I wasn't expecting. Then I got sick, literally twice. So overall, my perspective this trip hasn't exactly been the greatest thing in the world. On the other hand, if you look from her perspective, she came here without much of a plan. She got to come see these neat, interesting things. We have legitimately spent over 3 weeks here, so I mean, it's a good long time to be here. She didn't get sick at all. Hey, maybe that fruit thing has a point. But anyways, and so for her, it's been a good thing. And so this is something that you should be thinking about, like whenever you talk to anybody and whenever you're asking for anybody's opinion, because so many times the opinions that they are going to give you are going to be biased based on what they've dealt with and how they've interacted with things. So if you're going to be a budget backpacker, let's say going to Southeast Asia or going through India or something like that, right? And you talk with a business person, you talk with a CEO, then they're probably going to give you an opinion that doesn't have much to do with the life that you're going to live, right? So if they're used to going to India or Southeast Asia and spending $100, $200 a night for a room, you know, they have a driver, they have taxis, they're eating at Western quality establishments and all that kind of stuff, they're going to have an opinion of countries and experiences that is not going to be similar to somebody who literally has a budget of only $20 a day. Somebody who has a budget of $20 a day is going to have opinions about places that are not going to be similar to people that have a budget of $200 a day. Again, I do have to say, coming and doing this trip in Thailand, I've done it a little over a month doing the budget thing. Like I said, I was spending like $10, $15 a day back then, and now I've been spending $100 to $150 a day. And I do have to say, it is an entirely different experience, right? You know, when I went from Chiang Mai down to Koh Samui, I think that was like a two-day trek, right? I mean, like to get from Chiang Mai all the way down to Koh Samui was like a two-day trek. You know, it cost a bit of money, it was a lot of time, it was like 15, 16 hours of driving or whatever else. Whereas now, I had the money and time has changed, and so when we went from Siem Reap to Bangkok, I could simply grab a flight. And again, as I have to say, budget airlines are absolutely amazing things. But it changes the experience. It changes how you understand the environment. It changes the actual adventure you have. Somebody who bounces around using budget airlines is going to have a different experience than somebody that bounces around using minibuses, right? Somebody's in air-conditioned taxis all the time is going to have a different experience than somebody's in tuk-tuks and all that kind of stuff. So just something for you folks to be thinking about whenever you're talking about people and talking about their experiences and all that kind of thing, is to realize that everybody has different perspectives based on things like what their original expectations were. So again, with me and my wife, I had expectations coming to Thailand. She had no expectations coming to Thailand. Therefore, my expectations weren't fulfilled, and so that's theoretically a negative. She didn't have any expectations, so she could not have non-fulfilled expectations, if you know what I'm saying, right? So it's things like that to be thinking about, because again, so many people, this is one of the things I've talked about before in some of the videos over on Eli the Computer Guy, is like finding mentors. One of the big problems I see in life is that people don't select their mentors or their advisors well enough. Most of the time, they're just looking for anybody that will give them advice. Like, anybody will give me advice. But the problem is if you're finding people that are going to give you advice that don't want to live the same kind of life that you want to live, or don't want to have the same kind of experiences that you want to have, then they're going to give you advice that is skewed based on what their perspectives are. And so that's something that I think you have to think about. I think I had more brain power. I think food poisoning destroys your brain power. That's going to be my excuse for the day. Oh, I had a brain. I had a brain, my friend. It was a beautiful brain, my friend. What happened to my brain, my friend? Got eaten by a bacteria. Ugh. Yeah, I had this whole thing on perspective. Oh, it was this beautiful idea. I was going to talk about my wife's perspective. I was going to talk about my perspective. I was going to talk about the future perspective. Like this whole idea where you don't remember pain. Like it's really weird, a human condition. We're not built to remember pain. We're built to remember happiness and joy, but not pain. Like if you remember back on a... if you remember back on a happy time, you may laugh or smile, but if you look back on when you broke an arm or something, you don't remember the pain. It's not the same visceral type thing. And so also, you know, when you're talking with people about their perspective about past adventures or whatever, you do have to realize that they're going to smile and laugh a lot because we're just kind of intrinsically built that way. But they're not going to tell you about all the horrible things. Again, as I say, how many other YouTubers out there are gonna talk about sitting in a shower in Goa, crapping on themselves as the shower came down, right? People just aren't gonna talk about that. And so again, like when you're talking about perspectives and all that kind of stuff, so much of that, when you're talking about historical things, a lot of things get washed out. I was gonna say all that stuff, but I fear, my friends, I think I'm still sick. A, I'm still sick, and B, that Thai lady just kind of screwed up my entire train of thought. That old train of thought. And then this weird lady just sits down. It's like, hi. And you're just like, what do you want me to do? Oh, what? I don't know. Do not know. But again, that's the thing with Let's Live videos. You never know what you're really gonna get. Sometimes you're just gonna get like, I think you get like good stuff sometimes. And other times, you just kind of get me mumbling. I think today you're just kind of gonna get me mumbling. But oh well, we'll be back in nice 70 degree weather pretty soon. Very happy about that. So I've been talking to my wife about that with the travel trailer. So she's happy, excited about the travel trailer. So we'll get back, like I say, in about 48 hours. We'll be back in Dulles. Hop in the car, drive on sane roads, get home, have some good fresh organic oatmeal in the morning. Yummy. And then we're gonna start planning for our next trip. I am kind of wondering, like, since our travel trailer has been mothballed since like November, and it's been through the winter, what I'm thinking is maybe we should do like a week trip up to this place called Ohio Pile. It's up in the Laurel Highlands in Pennsylvania. It looks very nice, and I think this time of year it should be pretty nice. So there's like a Jellystone. Oh yeah, Jellystone. Yeah, with the Yogi Bear and all that. Hey, they're goofy as hell, but they're actually, Jellystones are pretty nice, let me tell you. But there's a Jellystone RV park up there. So what I'm thinking is maybe take it out and make sure for a week and make sure everything is still good. I don't think everything got winterized quite properly last year. So, you know, if something's gonna pop, I'd rather it pop a couple hours from home rather than when we're all the way up in New York or Massachusetts or Maine or whatever. So my thought is maybe we'll come back, like I say, spend a while at home, maybe go out for up to a week up to Ohio Pile, the Laurel Highlands. Laurel Highlands is absolutely beautiful if you're in the Pennsylvania area. Make sure everything works out, then go back home again. She has some stuff to do, and then we'll go up, like I say, to the Adirondacks. If you haven't been up to the Adirondacks is just one of those little, one of those gems, those hidden gems that so many people don't know about. Like, you hear about Yellowstone, obviously, you hear about all these great national parks, but the Adirondacks is absolutely just an amazing place. It's like this whole area of New York State. It's a huge chunk of New York State. And it's public lands and it's private lands, but it's one of those things where even the private land, like there's public land, which is, you know, parks, and then there's private land, and there's private, which is their small town, which is nice, because imagine like lots of parks, and then also with towns inside it. So if you want a good hot pizza that's not gonna give you deli belly, you can go to get a pizza or a beer. But beyond those towns, then you also have normal private land, but it being the Democratic state of New York, even though it's private land, there's like a crap ton of restrictions on what you're allowed to do with the land. Like, it's kind of goofy. It's kind of like, I know why I like to go to the Adirondacks, because it's so beautiful. On the other hand, I'm not sure why some people buy property in the Adirondacks, because there's so much you can't do with a property. It's like, I just brought 50 acres that I can't do anything with. And that lots of people have mandated right-of-ways through. So, you know, I own 50 acres that I can't keep people off of, and I can't necessarily do what I want to with. But hey, it only cost me $5 million. But the nice part is that's the thing, is like, so like when people buy land, they may buy like 50 acres, but they can't necessarily clear cut it. It's very difficult, to like build things on lakes or anything anymore. So it's really great. So you go up there and like, there's one of these, like with a lot of the lakes, like even when they build houses by the lake, so they're lakeshore houses, but you can't see the house from the lake. So if you're from one of the mountaintops and you look down at the lake, it looks like a pristine, beautiful lake with no houses or anything on it. And it's not that there's no houses there, it's that all the houses are set, you know, 30 feet back so that you can't actually see them. So there's all that kind of cool stuff there. So we'll go there to hopefully for the Adirondacks. We'll spend like 2 weeks there. And then I'd like to go to Acadia for 2 weeks. I'm not sure if the wife is too excited about Acadia, weirdly enough. Because that's where we actually went there as one of our first big trips, way back when we first got together. And then we went there for our honeymoon, way back when. And I was like, yay, we can go back to Acadia. She was like, hey, haven't we already done Acadia? So I'm not sure if we'll do Acadia. So we know we want to do the Adirondacks. Maybe we'll do Acadia, maybe we'll do something else. But that's kind of the plan right now. Hopefully as soon as I get my brain back. It is funny, like sitting here, I'm like, wow, I do not have the brain power. My brain power has left me. The little deli belly bacteria is like, got it into my brain. So yeah, with that, I think we're just gonna call it a day. Because I don't think I can give you the full Eli today. Maybe I can give you the full Eli tomorrow. I will try to give you the full Eli tomorrow. Because maybe we do have enough bandwidth. Because if I did a video in the morning, I could actually have it uploaded and ready for you folks. Maybe, if I have enough brain power. I don't know. It's funny. It's like, ooh. This is food poisoning for you. But again, I know this sounds like goofy as shit. And probably like 90% of the people dropped off the video at this point going, Eli's lost his brain. I'll come back when he's got his brain again. But again, one of the cool things about doing these Let's Live videos, and one of the things about doing like these vlogs every day, and doing it when I'm happy, and doing it when I'm sick, is it shows you things, I think it puts things into context in ways that you don't really grasp until you see it. And what I mean by this is, so we're in Thailand right now, we were just in Cambodia. And one of the things that they talk about is that disease, just disease itself, takes away so much of the GDP from these countries, right? So they say like malaria is brutal. Like malaria takes away like 5% GDP growth from a lot of countries. But, and you sit there and you sit there and you think about it and you're like, yeah, well, haha, yeah, that's funny. But it's not really that big a deal. Those people just need to work harder, right? Those lazy people just need to work harder. It's, yeah, I understand they got malaria. But one of the interesting things, like with me sitting here trying to talk to you guys through kind of like this fog of food poisoning, is realistically the food poisoning I have. I mean, it's just food poisoning. I'm not trying to make it out to more than this. I mean, fuck, it sucks. But you know, I truly didn't have to go to the hospital for it. But what's interesting is you think how relatively intelligent that I am. And you think about how verbose and generally clear-headed I am. And then you see like 3 days after getting the food poisoning, I'm still this foggy. And then again, you think of countries where, again, food hygiene isn't really a thing. And you think about how much it damages their economy, right? I mean, think about like if you got food poisoning on a relatively regular basis or any of these diseases and how much it just slows you down and how much it just kind of fogs your brain. So that even if you did start out smart, even if you did start out competent, by the end, you're just kind of a slug. You're just like, ooh, right? Because it is interesting. It's like, huh, yeah. Something to ponder. Ugh. But anyways. No, are you still there? Not even joking, I'm just like, rah. Oh. So yeah, I think we'll call it a day. I'm gonna go back to the hotel room, crash out on nice ice-cold air conditioning. But again, one of those things to be thinking about. It's funny, it is interesting. Because yeah, you think about how screwed up this is making me. And then, I mean, think about that on just a national scale. That'd be brutal. That would be brutal. Anyways, I don't know what else to say. With that, we will call it a day, and hopefully I will have some brain power for you tomorrow. I'm not saying that I will. I am definitely not saying that I will have brain power for you tomorrow, but maybe I will, and we'll get this up to the full 60 minutes. I really feel bad here. I really feel like I'm letting you folks down. Like right now, 37 minutes of talking. That's just wrong. That is not acceptable. That is not acceptable. I should be giving you full hours. Sickness, disease, food poisoning isn't a bloody excuse. I guess it is a good excuse, but anyways. Yeah, I'm just... So we're just gonna leave it with that for today. And hopefully when I talk to you folks tomorrow, I'll be a tiny bit more coherent.